What's going on, guys? We have some more Tank Tucker today. The UNC Tar Heels are taking on NC State. It's a battle between two top 25 teams, and it is a rivalry game. Quickly, we will check up on the Heisman watch and the conference standings. And look at that. Tank Tucker goes from first to fourth just because he has a bye week. Come on, man. And currently in the ACC, North Carolina is only 7th, but here's a big game against a number 2 team in the conference, so let's get into the game. Alright, well, the Wolfpack will start it out with the ball. We're looking for a victory today, and we'll take... Okay, I guess we got the ball first, never mind. First play is going to be Tank Tucker running it out of the flats, and quick pass looking left, incomplete pass. Let's... Okay, I guess we can't run the ball. Alrighty then. Second and 10 from our own 21-yard line. And Tucker not really open. And there we go, a completed pass for 5 yards. And, okay, we'll go with the play action just because we have good play action blocking. And Tank Tucker can hopefully keep the quarterback upright so we can make a complete pass and get a first down. Quick pass left, right side, actually. And it is knocked down. So that first drive results in a 3-and-out. Can we run the ball, please? That's all I'm asking. All-American running back, 99 overall, 403 pounds. Can we run the ball? Over the middle, wide open. Can you hit the open receiver? No. Can't do anything right in this game, I guess. Anyways, I'm going to take power into my own hands and call my own play. We're going to run the ball. Block that outside linebacker. Oh, the middle guy is going to get me now. 1 yard gain for Tucker on his opening carry. Come on, guys. 3rd and 9 now for Tucker. Out of the shotgun is Renner. 2 receivers right, 1 left. And that was a pass on the right side. It fell incomplete, which means another punt for this offense. Not a good start, and then we give up a touchdown. Come on, guys. NC State, I remember this team. They have played us very tough in the past, and they are not to be taken lightly. But we should probably get this win anyways. There's a first down. Tucker makes his grab. Sometimes you gotta take power into your own hands. Do whatever you can do to get the ball, get the first downs. And now we'll get a second carry. And there we go, more than 1 yard this time. That's about 7-8 yards, making it 2nd and 2 after the 8 yard gain. Which we will go out of the shotgun. Tucker is going to get the handoff and dodge the defensive tackle and go up past the opposing 40-yard line. And then we'll take a TV timeout. And Tucker's off the field, and man, his stamina is just on a... is horrible. I don't know how else to explain it. Anyways, he is 403 pounds, so the laws of physics are not going to allow him to stay in the game as much as I would like him to. And then Renner gets sacked. We're not going to waste an extra play on a run in this situation. I'll just try to keep him upright this time, see if anybody's blitzing, and hopefully he can hit that tight end for a first down or a big gain or something. All right. And there we go! First down to the star receiver, I believe, into NC State territory, up to the 30-yard line. Happy with that play. We got a 7-7 game in the second quarter. And we're running a lot of shotgun. Do we always run this much shotgun? I didn't notice. Over the middle, touchdown! Just gotta split the safeties on those post routes. Those are what tear up those cover 2 defenses right there. We are up by 7 now. And up by 14 now. I don't know what happened, but I like it. 1st and 10. 2:45 remaining in the second quarter. Who's going to blitz? You want to blitz? I didn't think so. And that's going to be a first down to the tight end who took the short pass, took up the right side, got some yards after the catch. Why does Tank Tucker only have 3 carries? This is an issue. We have a 14-point lead. We can afford to run the ball. And I did not call for that ball because I did not want it, and it resulted in a 1 yard gain. You could have thrown it to somebody else. Let's run power offense. 2nd and 9 for the Tar Heels. Tucker takes the carry, goes right, got some blockers, cuts it outside. One guy's going to try to meet him at about the 10-yard line, and oh, look at the spin move, but he gets down at the 1-yard line. Big gain for Tank Tucker. You got it. pick a better play than that. We're calling timeout. That's a stupid play. That's a stupid play, too. Or toss. You guys are ridiculous play callers. Yeah, we're going to call all three timeouts then if we can. Oh, a normal run. It took three timeouts to get it. First and goal. Hand off up the middle. And touchdown Tar Heels. 21-point lead. Laying the smackdown on the Wolfpack in the first half with a 21-point lead. And we got the ball again. Let's pound it up the middle. We got to get back in the top of the Heisman race. And runs like this is what's going to help. First down for Tucker. Got 80 yards on the day. Let's take it easy and block now with a minute left in the first half. And so, in a few more episodes, we'll be getting close to Tucker's final season at UNC, which means I can finally get one of these guys into Madden 12. It's taken me forever. Anyways, handoff Tucker up the middle, taken down after a gain of... That was a gain of 5, I guess, when you're as big and powerful as Tank Tucker. First contact means 5-yard gain because you're falling forward. Anyways, it looks like we're just trying to run out the clock and get to the halftime. Oh, thanks for holding. So, Ben Bell. Let's go deep. I'm sick of this running the ball before halftime. Just get to the half all content with the score. Play aggressive. Dagger this team in the heart. Deep pass is what I'm talking about. Who cares if it's intercepted or incomplete? At least you took the chance. Anyways, it resulted in no points, and now we're in the second half. Still with our 21-point lead. Very comfortable at this point. 4 minutes remaining in the third quarter, and Tucker going out for a pass. Don't throw it to me. Linebacker's coming over. And then I'll catch the ball in the middle of the field. Tank cross over into Wolfpack territory to the 48-yard line. I like what I see. We are playing very powerful right now. Very powerful football. And we'll do some power offense. Great block by the receiver. Oh boy, way to stay in bounds. Tank Tucker, he's a nimble little fella. Big fella, actually. And he stays in bounds, picks up some extra yardage inside of the 30-yard line now. And we're going to stick to the power offense attack. But, come on. Make sure you block the lineman before you go to the second level. I mean... those guys are big. They can take down Tank. Second and 9. More power offense. And there we go. Back to the middle of the field. Short gain of 5. As Tucker will now leave the field. And, well, they didn't score. Probably because Tank wasn't on the field. But he has a buck 11 on the ground so far. Got to get those numbers. The Heisman watch is ours. There we go. Come on, man. First down, but how about a touchdown? That would have been pretty neat. Anyways, we got to do a shotgun draw. Let's see, we got two linebackers in the middle. See if we can get some blocks. Nope, and we're going to hold on top of it. Wonderful. Gerald Taylor making it first and 17. I also want to do some more Jackhammer. I plan on playing him later today. I'm not sure if I'm going to do a live commentary or if I'm going to just play a series of games and then edit it into a 4-game video, just a little 10-minute special, just to get some progress moving along. He is in the beginning of his junior season, and so it'd be nice to get some progress and be consistent with all these series. And then a first down for Tank. That's all he does. And then he leaves the field. It's a Burger King Whopper or whatever he does on the sideline. Second and 19. That drive must have run out. I think we were past midfield. Anyways, the score has been the same for this entire half. And Tucker makes a catch, but no gain on the play. Just trying to get those numbers. That quarterback from UCF just totally vultured the Heisman last year. It was Tank's for the taking. And, you know, it was snatched right from under us. Right from under Tank. He couldn't even see it coming. How many extras I got? 10? All right. Got the ball at midfield. Let's see if we can get our touchdown under our belt for this game. comfortable lead, but we'll add on a little bit of insurance if we can get some good runs. Power running up the middle will take us to the fourth quarter on a 7-yard gain. Okay, we'll do it. Read option, just so I can show you how worthless this play is. And Tucker gets the handoff. Might as well just hand the ball off to him in the first place. First and 10 for Tank. And quick pass right side. I'm surprised that wasn't intercepted. Looked like he had to look like he was in position, but nonetheless, it is a first down. Clock is ticking. Let's just get out of here with a victory. Go celebrate. And middle of the field, middle of the field. Oh, that was probably intended for me. Might have been. Anyways, speed option. Oh boy, this could be a total disaster. Matter of fact, it's probably going to be that safety's going to come down. Or the linebacker, yep. I was ahead of the running back, quarterback anyways, so that was a mistake. And I probably made another mistake by calling for a screen pass. But you know what? With a 21-point lead, he can take some chances now and then. Come on! I suck at the screen pass. I don't like letting the computer run the route for him. I feel like I'm not even playing the game then. Anyway, speaking of not playing, Tucker is done for the rest of the game. But we win 35-7. And so the Tar Heels get a victory. Tank Tucker with 132 yards rushing, a touchdown along with 40 yards receiving. And so 19 total touches for 172 yards. Let's see how that did for our Heisman race, whatever you want to call it, Heisman race. How it did for Tank Tucker's Heisman hopes. Alright, well, Tank Tucker goes up one spot after that performance. Still got to get rid of that quarterback from UCF and Ray Hood from the Ohio State Buckeyes. Four carries, 23 yards. You should not be in first place. Tank Tucker should. You had a pretty good game, too. One touchdown. Yeah, Tucker had one touchdown. And so, guys, thank you for watching. Next episode, we'll see Tank Tucker and the UNC Tar Heels take on the Maryland Terrapins in another ACC matchup. And so, we try to get our eighth victory on the season in the next episode. Thank you, guys, for watching, and I will see you next time.